This is ABC.
Tonight, live from the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, this is the 20th annual American Music Awards. With your hosts, Bobby Brown, Gloria Estefan, and Wynonna. Scheduled to appear are Alabama, Joan Baez, Pat Benatar, Mary J. Blige, Michael Bolton, Bon Jovi, Boys to Men, Garth Brooks, Brooks and Dunn, Evo Bryson, Evan Campbell, Natalie Cole, Billy Ray Cyrus, Celine Dion, and Vogue, Firehouse, Mick Fleetwood, John Fogerty, Lita Ford, Jerry Garcia, Debbie Gibson, Vince Gill, Amy Grant, Herbie Hancock, Alan Jackson, Michael Jackson, Jodeci, Gladys Knight, Chris Cross, Patti LaBelle, Huey Lewis, Trey Lorenz, Matt Cobra, Richard Marx, Kathy Mattea, Reba McEntire, Christine McVie, Metallica, Eddie Money, Laurie Morgan, Motley Crue, Mr. Big, Eddie Murphy, Shabba Ranks, Restless Heart, Run DMC, Carlos Santana, Gordon Brown, Joan Sakana, Grace Slick, Michael W. Smith, Harry Smyth, Stephen Stills, Elizabeth Taylor, TLC, Tanya Tucker, Ugly Kid Jones, Robin Williams, Weird Al Yankovic, and Dwight Yoakam. The 20th Annual American Music Awards, brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers with that fresh, pure, natural taste. Nothing beats a Bud. McDonald's. What you want is what you get guaranteed at McDonald's today. Nissan. It's time to expect more from a car. And Diet Coke, as a reminder to taste it all.
And now, here are the hosts of the 20th Annual American Music Awards, Bobby Brown, Gloria Estefan, and Wynonna.
We're very proud to have the chance to host this very special anniversary edition of the American Music Awards.
Since the first show in 1974, there has been 60 hosts, and fans all around the country have enjoyed over 200 performances of every kind of contemporary music.
There have been 750 winners since Roberta Flack picked up the first award 20 years ago, which means there have been well over 2,000 very nervous nominees trying to look calm and collected.
Tonight, we'll find out who's big in pop and rock, soul and R&B, country, rap, heavy metal, and adult contemporary.
To present our first award of the evening, here is a star who simply became 1992's Music Star of the Year. Ladies and gentlemen, Garth Brooks.
Thanks a lot. Well, I'm a year late, but I'm here. It feels pretty good to be here tonight. First of all, I'd like to start off by personally thanking Travis Tritt for sitting in for me last year and doing a wonderful job. Personally, I'd like to thank Dick Clark and Miss Natalie Cole for their undying concern, the thousands of letters and prayers pertaining to our problem that we had flying out to this show last year with my wife's pregnancy. Everything is wonderful. I think it's only fitting to do the female country artist with someone that's I've become a very big admirer of. She's a good friend of mine to help present this award, and my lovely wife, Sandy.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be here. Are y'all ready?
You've got the winner is, so here comes the nominee.
For favorite female artist country. Reba McEntire. Laurie Morgan. Tanya Tucker.
Trying to find their way.
Wynonna.
And the winner is McIntyre. Thank you all very much. I'll accept this award for all the folks at MCA who I'm very proud to be a part of. Everyone at Starstruck, a great team to get to work with. My family, my manager, Narville Blackstock, and all the fans who voted for me. Thank you all very much. I love you.
When we return, find out the winners of the Pop Rock and Soul R&B Female Awards and enjoy four great hits from Gloria Estefan on the 20th Annual American Music Awards.
To present the second award of the evening, here are Amy Grant and Richard Marx.
Hey, the nominees for Soul R&B Favorite Female Artist are
Mary J. Blige, Mariah Carey, Patti LaBelle, and Vanessa Williams.
And the winner is...
And the winner is Patti LaBelle.
Thank you very much. And I'm not going to be real crazy and all that other kind of stuff that, hey, Gladys, this is an award that I can share with people like Gladys Knight and all those wonderful friends of mine. I love you. And I love you, MCA Records. And I've never been nominated for an American Music Award in my life. And I thank you so much, fans up in the balcony. Thank you so much.
Our next performer has lived her life with great courage, determination, and generosity. After surviving a terrible accident, she came back to continue her great career.
She's amazing. She's had 10 top 10 singles from her greatest hits album. Ladies and gentlemen, our co-host, Gloria Estefan.
you.
To present the favorite pop rock female award is an Oscar-winning composer and a past winner of this award. Here are Pat Benatar and Herbie Hancock.
Well, Pat, since you've won this category so many times before, I bet you know how the nominees feel.
They probably feel just like I did, real anxious to know who the winner is.
Well, let's get right to it.
Okay. The nominees for Pop Rock Favorite Female Artist are...
Mariah Carey. Amy Grant. Bonnie Raitt. Vanessa Williams.
And the winner is... Mariah Carey. Thank you so much. I'm so excited, I can't believe it. I wrote this list, I thought it was bad luck, but I wrote it anyway. Okay. First of all, I'd just like to thank God for every blessing in my life. It's so incredible. Thank you. Tommy Mottola, my best friend. I love you. Thank you so much. My manager, Randy Hoffman, everyone at Horizon Entertainment, Donny Einer, everyone at Columbia Records, Sony Music, my family, all my friends, Karen Rizzo. And most of all, I couldn't do this without you. The fans up there, I love you. You made this happen for me. I love you. I can't thank you enough.
The top single awards in Crisscross perform next on the 20th Annual American Music Awards.
Tuesday, it's comedy in the fast lane when Jesse applies the twins to an upscale preschool.
He embellished on our application. Not too many two-year-olds are proficient on the bassoon.
An all-new Full House.
All right!
Then Mark and the girls plan to hit the slopes.
Better watch out for the stream.
Hanging with Mr. Cooper, Tuesday after Full House.
Our next two presenters, both are nominees tonight. As a matter of fact, one of them just picked up an award earlier tonight. They both make great music. Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Jackson and Patti LaBelle.
Well, you know, all through the years it's been true. A big hit single comes from just the right combination between the artist and the song.
And in all three cases tonight, the mix was just right. So which one's going to win? Well, here are the choices.
You tell them, Alan.
End of the Road, Boys to Men. Woo! I'll Be There, Mariah Carey. Woo! Under the Bridge, Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Chili Peppers. And the winner is... I think you know, the End of the Road, Boys to Men.
First of all, we'd like to thank our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for putting us here today. We want to thank the two producers, the three producers of this great song, L.A. Reid, Babyface, and Darrell Simmons. We want to thank our record company, our family, our friends, Mr. Michael Bivens, Mr. Gerald Busby, Mr. Dick Clark, the American Music Awards, and everybody up there that bought the record and supported us for 2 years. Thank you very much, and we love you.
Chris Smith calls himself Daddy Mac. Chris Kelly calls himself Mac Daddy. Everyone calls them Chris Cross. Give it up.
Now I'm the type of hip hop showstopper. I break them off proper, unlike them other teeny boppers that continue to say you never ever come my way. I'm waiting for that alphabet coup to make my day, so I can chop and chop and drop them little punks quick and teach them never to mess with this crossed out kid. But really though, you kill me, don't pretend that you wanna dump mad, cause I'm bad and we made 5 million people jump.
You should know that I'm Chris Cross, and I'll be having anything today. As you stand here totally crossed staff, we commit to make ya. The Mac Dad will make you
jump.
My Daddy Mac will make you
jump around against the
Chris Cross to make you
DJ Nas, break them all, son.
Come on, pump your fist like this.
Let me see ya.
Pump your fist like this.
Let me see ya.
Pump your fist like this.
Let me see ya.
Pump your fist like this.
Warm it up, Chris.
I'm about to
warm it up, Chris.
That's what I was born into.
Warm it up, Chris.
I'm about to
warm it up, Chris.
Many times I heard you wrong, but you can't touch this. I'm kicking a temper from the bitch, you're saying too much, Chris. So feel the fire of the one they call the Mac Dad. The fire's what I pack and what I pack is real bad. I like to grab a hold of yourself and never let go. Do the jump, do the hump and say,
ho! Oh!
Then that's the state of mind I'm in, huh. With rhyme after rhyme, I win.
I'm the wrong rhythm for sucks to be messing with. Cause when I put the mic on my hand, I start
wrecking it.
They call me the D-A-double, do I ever see? Fain another brother, bad as me. What I
let go,
something from the head of word. Little brother kicking rhymes like you never ever heard. Daddy, if them all shooting a gift like a gun,
Chris Cross, show them how it's done.
Dump fools around my way, getting high up gun smoke. And I ain't talking about the high like Enzo. The kind of high to make you call your kids, folks. Until Mo Johnny's dead, a 14-year-old kid put a nod to his head. All because he wants that kid, he was born. Give me that, why you better give me them Jordans? Johnny tried to jet, homie wasn't here. Johnny tried to run, got dead in the back. Now tell me what happened to the way things used to be. Cause at this rate, there'd be no future G. From the law, y'all learn that to play a fight too long, you're bound to get burned. This ain't a small thing I'm addressing, it's a big thing. Take it from the daddy as a lesson. It's a shame the way this thing goes down. How one lay it down, this is show we don't play around. He goes to sleep with a head full of anger, yeah. And wakes up a full energized headbanger, yeah. Talking about a tip, get a basket. Not knowing the next day he'll be laying in the casket. So what you think of that, son? In the arcade they play in the game, they run. Some like Pac-Man, same name, but the game is to put it in a second. Run it to the next board and get down the food standing in the way of the door. There's no board, no points. And in this game, this is all Pac-Man wants. The game, the ghost, the always blooming. You slip up and they smoke ya.
Check, check, check it out. And you don't stop.
It's a
shame, it's a shame, it's a shame.
Oh, yeah. It's a
check, check, check it out.
Yeah. It's a
yeah,
peace,
yeah,
y'all, we outta here.
To present the favorite country single award, Motley Crue.
How you doing? We got a brand new lead singer, Mr. John Karabi here. And we're going to let him announce the winner.
Well, don't say anything now, John. Just save it.
Here's our, here are the three nominees for Favorite Country Single Award.
For Favorite Single Country, The River, Garth Brooks. Achy Breaky Heart, Billy Ray Cyrus. I Still Believe in You, Vince Gill.
And the winner is... Achy Breaky Heart, Billy Ray Cyrus.
Thank you very much. As always, I'd like to thank my record company, Mercury Records, for taking a chance on me. My band, Sly Dog. My producers, Jim and Joe. My mom and dad and my family for instilling inside my heart and my soul the belief in God and prayer. And most importantly of all, tonight this award means more to me than any award that I've received yet, because this award is from you, the fans. You people have made this happen. And I want to tell you something. I want to tell you something. There have been those people, perhaps due to paranoia or insecurities, or perhaps they consider themselves a self-proclaimed critic. But tonight, this award is from you, the fans, and as far as I'm concerned, to those people who don't like Achy Breaky Heart, here's a quarter, cause someone who cares.
Next, a first, a great duet by Reba McEntire and Vince Gill, and the nominees for Favorite Soul R&B Single Record of the Year on the American Music Awards.
Tuesday is the first couple of comedy.
Hi there.
Look who's visiting Roseanne.
Oh, the you ain't woman ain't nothing.
It's country queen Loretta Lynn and the comedy queen Roseanne. Then, can you believe they want to replace Jackie?
Funeral scene, huh?
Yeah.
Am I in it?
Yeah.
How come I don't have no lines?
Closed casket.
Jackie Thomas after Roseanne, Tuesday.
I'd like to mention the red ribbons you see being worn this evening. They indicate concern for the victims of AIDS, and they raise awareness of the need for research and treatment to wipe out this terrible disease. To present the Soul and R&B Favorite Single Award are two popular artists. She's a legendary superstar with a long list of hits, and with her is a brand new star, a man that I've known and loved for many years. I've sung with him, I've toured with him, and this year, one of his big hits stayed in the top 10 for 11 consecutive weeks. Ladies and gentlemen, Gladys Knight and John Secada.
Tonight's nominations are based on record sales information compiled by Radio and Records, a leading music trade publication, and the SoundScan point-of-sale tracking system.
Now here are the nominations for the Soul R&B Single.
For Favorite Single Soul R&B. Remember the Time, Michael Jackson. Honey Love, R. Kelly and Public Announcement. Somebody Loves You, Baby, you know who it is, Patti LaBelle.
Okay, and the winner is
I'm nervous.
Yes, you are. Hey, remember the time, Michael Jackson!
Thank you very much. I love you up there. I'd like to thank everyone at Sony Music, especially Mr. Morita, Mickey Schulhoff, Tommy Mottola, Dave Glue, Bruce Woodian, Quincy Jones, Sandy Gallen, and Jim Morey, and of course, all my fans, I love you.
The group presenting our next award is proof that good things really do come in twos. They are two sets of brothers who turn their double duets into a double platinum debut album. Please welcome Jodeci.
What's up, everybody? The nominees for Rap Hip Hop Favorite
Artist. Mr. Dalvin, hold up.
Before we give the nominees out, we want to say we was nominated for an award. We doubt if we win, but if we don't, we'd like to say thanks to God, thanks to all our fans, especially. The nominees for Favorite Rap Hip Hop Favorite Artist are Criss Cross, Sir Mix-a-Lot, and TLC. And the winner is Baby Got Back, Sir Mix-a-Lot. Baby Got Back.
First of all, I want to thank Dick Clark because he had hard enough to put rap in here in the first place, because rap is legitimate and it's here to stay on the real. I want to thank Criss Cross, TLC, but more importantly, I want to thank artists like Run DMC, LL Cool J, who made all this possible. You know what I'm saying? They broke ground. I want to thank God for obvious reasons and all the booty people in America. Yeah, I like big butts, baby.
Down through the years, famous country soloists have gotten together to sing unforgettable duets. People like Conway Twitty and Loretta Lynn, Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton, George Jones and Tammy Wynette. Tonight, we have something very special for you. Ladies and gentlemen, a winner here tonight, Reba McEntire and Vince Gill.
Looking back over the years, of all the things I've always meant to say, but the words didn't come easily. So many times through empty fears, of all the nights I tried to pick up the phone, so scared of who might be me away. 'Cause the heart won't lie.
You can live your alibi. You can see you're lost inside a foolish disguise. The hard-won lie.
Long after tonight, will you still hear my voice through the radio? Old desires make us act carelessly. Long after tonight, after the fire, after the scattered ashes fly, through the four winds blown and gone, will you come back to me? Will you try?
The heart won't lie. Sometimes life gets in the way.
But there's one thing that won't change. I know I've tried.
The heart won't lie. You can live your alibi. You can see your lust inside a foolish disguise.
Still to come, exciting performances by Boys to Men, Billy Ray Cyrus, Michael Bolton, and more when the American Music Awards returns. The 20th Annual American Music Awards will continue in a moment.
New reports suggest cellular phones can cause brain cancer at 11.
Welcome back to the American Music Awards, where we're celebrating our 20th anniversary with some special memories. You know, during our first 10 years, country band, duo, or group winners included the Carter Family, the Statler Brothers, the Oak Ridge Boys, and Conway and Loretta. But for these past 10 years, one name has echoed through the Shrine Auditorium each and every year. Listen.
Alabama.
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 And we love all of you.
Presenting our first band, duo, or group award is a band that does it all, from acoustic ballads to hard rock and blues. Their newest album is called Lean Into It. Here are Eric, Billy, Paul, and Pat, Mr. Big.
This award is for country band, duo, or group.
Band meaning people who play.
Group meaning people who sing.
And duo meaning duo.
These nominees cover all those definitions. You'll see.
But it'll do 0 to 60.
For favorite band, duo, or group, country.
I'm in a hurry to get things done.
Alabama. Brooks and Dunn. Sawyer Brown.
And the winner is...
Alabama.
First of all, I know this has been said many times, but thank God for getting us through all these years. It's been wonderful. We appreciate all the things that he's done for us. I've never said hello to my mother. Mama, I love you so much, and Dad, I miss you. And ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank all the fans all across the world, all across the United States, America, the world, our record company, RCA Records, Dale Morrison Associates, Keith Fowler Promotions, the fans. You guys take over. I'm excited.
He said it all. Happy birthday, Dad. Here's your present.
Thank you.
In 1956, Elvis Presley's Don't Be Cruel set a new record by remaining at the top of the charts, the singles charts, for 11 consecutive weeks. Now, 36 years later, these guys from Philly broke that record. Staying at the top of the charts for 13 weeks. They're winners tonight. Give it up for my boys, Boys to Men.
Hurt me and just ran out with that other fella. Baby, I knew about it. I just didn't care. You just don't understand how much I love you, do you? I'm here for you. I'm not out to go out there and cheat all night. Just like you did, baby, but that's all right. I love you anyway. And I'm still gonna be here for you till my dying day, baby. Right now, I'm just in so much pain, girl. Cause you just won't come back to me. Yes, baby, my heart is gone. My heart hurts, baby. Yes, I feel pain too. Baby, please.
Yeah.
Take two artists with wonderful voices, put them together with the right song, and you can make magic. In the case of our next two presenters, their duet of Beauty and the Beast made musical history. Here are Peebo Bryson and Celine Dion.
The adult contemporary category has room for all kinds of artists.
This year's nominees include a folk country pop singer, a Latin hitmaker, and a really fine singer-songwriter. Here they are.
For favorite new artist, adult contemporary, K.D. Lang. John Secada. Patti Smyth.
And the winner is Katie Lang.
Thank you. Thanks. I'm very lucky I had 8 years to prepare for this. First of all, I would like to thank the people who make the music with me, Greg Penny, Mark Vermeer, my creative partner Ben Mink, my manager Larry Wanagas, and the people at Warner Brothers who are very important to me, Carl Scott, Dino Barbas, thank you very much for pushing this thing all the way to the top. Jennifer Grossbert, and thank you so much for everything, and thank you very much to the listeners who welcomed me into this new genre. Thank you, I appreciate it.
To present the award for Soul R&B Band, Duo, or Group is an exciting trio of new stars. Two of them are at the forefront of the reggae beat, and the other had a double platinum R&B debut album. Here are Shabba Ranks, Mad Cobra, and Mary J. Blige.
How y'all feeling out there? I want to say what's up to all my fans and thank y'all for making Mary J. Blige who she is today.
Yeah, and to all the people of America, Jamaica, we love you. Yo, Mary, congratulations on a great year.
Thanks, Shabba. It's been a good year for all of us.
Yeah. Let's introduce nominees for Soul and R&B Band, Duet or Group.
For favorite band, duo or group, Soul, R&B. Boys to Men. En Vogue. Jodeci.
And the winner is
Boyz II Men.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus.
Let me hold that.
Yes, Jesus.
This one we're going to make short and sweet. This one is for the man that has given us everything that we have.
Thank you, Jesus.
And his
Thank
family. You, his name is Mr. Khalil Roundtree. We love you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, over the past 2 years, we've lost many of our outstanding musical artists. From jazz, there was bebop innovator Dizzy Gillespie, the incomparable Miles Davis, and the great sax man Stan Getz. Country lost pea picker Tennessee Ernie Ford, King of the Road Roger Miller, who hosted our show twice, and the Grand Ole Opry's Roy Acuff. Motown fans will miss my guys Mary Wells and early lead singers Eddie Kendricks and David Ruffin of The Temptations. In England, they mourn the passing of Queen's vocalist and entertainer, Freddie Mercury.
Freddie Mercury was something special. Quite simply, he was one of the most important figures in rock and roll over the last 20 years.
Freddie and his group Queen influenced the generation of fans, some of whom became today's stars.
When I was a kid, I was told that rock and roll wasn't music. Queen was my proof, my evidence that these people were rock.
Many rock superstars joined Queen in a Wembley Stadium farewell to Freddie. So we'd like to say to Dizzy, Miles, Stan, Ernie, Roger, Roy, Mary, Eddie, David, and Freddie, you were all champions, and we'll remember you that way, always.
A quiet dinner for two?
What's your side of the table for?
Home improvement. Then Kelly wants to give her money away.
Do you have any idea how much $50,000 could help a cause like the rainforest?
Well, there's a waste of money. They're not even going to be around in 10 years.
Coach, it's the Bad Boys of Comedy Wednesday.
There are not many women singer-guitarists turning out a powerful kind of hard rock music these days, but she is. There are not many men singer-guitarists turning out a powerful kind of hard country music these days, but he is. To tell us about the Pop Rock Band Duo or Group Award, here are Lita Ford and Dwight Yoakam.
The nominees for Pop Rock Band Duo or Group are two top established rock bands.
The third nominee is a hip-hop and rap duo. The nominees are...
Genesis.
Criss Cross. And U2. And the winner is...
Let me open this. Genesis.
Genesis can't be with us tonight, and we're both very happy to accept on their behalf this award. Thank you.
His voice is phenomenal. He's last year's winner of the American Music Award for Pop Rock Male Vocalist. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Michael Bolton.
Do each and every little thing.
Look for the light through the pouring rain. You know that's a game that I hate to lose. Feeling the strain.
This next presenter's first two albums are approaching platinum, and it seems like her third will do the same thing. The two men with her released their first album last year, went gold. Three singles from the album went straight to number one. To present our award for adult contemporary album, here are Lori Morgan and Brooks and Dunn.
Final test of an artist's consistency.
Well, if you mean by that that all the performances on the record are good, then we agree.
So these adult contemporary nominees were all consistent, so you guys check them out.
For favorite album, adult contemporary. Unplugged, Mariah Carey. Can't Dance, Genesis.
I'm just standing here selling everything. Hey, welcome to the comfort.
Comfort Zone, Vanessa Williams.
You need to be loved like you need to be. Welcome to.
And the winner is... Unplugged, Mariah Carey.
Once again, I love you. I can't thank you enough. Thank you, everybody at retail, everybody at radio. You've been here from the beginning. I love you, and I love all of you. This is for you. I love you. Thank you.
The American Music Awards has always honored the favorite artists of the American record-buying public. Now, with recent developments around the world, the time has come to recognize artists whose popularity and impact cross national boundaries. To tell us about the first recipient of the International Artist Award, here is a legendary star whose fame also extends around the globe, Miss Elizabeth Taylor.
Besides being a friend of tonight's honoree, I'm also his greatest fan. You better believe it. I'm also very aware of the enormous accomplishments that make him the logical recipient of this prestigious award.
Well, he wrote an international anthem that has become the biggest selling single of all time.
We are the world. We are the children.
We are the world. We are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start here.
After We Are the World, Michael Jackson decided to see the world for himself. He saw it and it saw him. The Bad and Dangerous tours have taken Michael to 30 different countries, some of them several times over, where he played to a record-breaking 6.5 million fans. It seems quite a few of the fans were outside the stadiums. It's easy to tell the fans really love Michael.
He's just the best, basically.
Great. One and only.
Never.
Michael will live forever.
My angel, your king of pop.
He's such a good-looking bloke.
Michael, je t'aime beaucoup.
Et la scola.
It was just magic.
The world man is the best entertainer in the world.
He's just the best performer that ever lived.
Fans may be just a little too much.
Michael
is the first artist ever to have 4 consecutive albums sell 167 million copies internationally. Off the Wall, the first time a solo artist had 4 top 10 singles in one album.
so long.
Thriller is simply the biggest selling album of all time. Bad is the second biggest selling album ever. At the present time, Dangerous is outpacing both Bad and Thriller, making Dangerous this year's largest selling album. Apart from albums and concert tours, Michael's humanitarian activities have shown his continuing concern about many of the global problems the world is facing.
Thank you for all the love and hope you're giving to the world, the children, to all the living.
Michael's work with disadvantaged young people and those with disabilities reflect his profound commitment to children.
I promise you, as long as I'm alive, I'll do my best to help heal the world. So now that Michael has definitely seen the world, where to next?
Record-shattering accomplishments, Michael truly can be called the King of Pop. Now to tell us, what's written on this award from New York City, there is another of Michael's friends and fans, Eddie Murphy.
Hi, Michael.
Knowing how uncomfortable you feel when someone says something nice to you right up in your face, I went 3,000 miles away to do this. Now, the inscription on your award says, in recognition of his record-breaking international concert tours and his album sales and his heartfelt efforts to make this world a better place, the American Music Awards presents its first International Artist Award to Michael Jackson, January 25th, 1993. And in addition, that's not all, in addition, the American Music Awards are proud to announce that when the award is given in the future, it'll be known as the Michael Jackson International Artist Award. So, congratulations, Michael. I know you should be smiling from ear to ear. I know you better smile even deeper than that. I want to see gums. That's how deep I want to see the smile. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Jackson.
I love you very much, Elizabeth Taylor. Teddy Riley, you're a genius. Thank you, Eddie. Thank you, all my friends. Traveling the world has been a great education for me. And if there is one insight I've had, it is this. Wherever you go, in every country, on every continent, people yearn and hunger for only one thing, to love and be loved. Love transcends international boundaries and it heals the wounds of hatred, racial prejudice, bigotry, and ignorance. It is the ultimate truth at the heart of all creation. I would also like to thank God and my mother and father, Catherine and Joseph Jackson. Thank you once again. I love you all.
On this 20th anniversary edition, 20 years of American Music Awards memories, and an exciting Bobby Brown production coming up next. The 20th Annual American Music Awards will continue in a moment.
After the Music Awards, join the party tonight at 11 on 7.
The 20th Annual American Music Awards brought to you by Diet Coke, as a reminder to taste it all. Taco Bell, every single bite makes your mouth rock and roll. And Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Welcome back to the 20th Annual American Music Awards. Since tonight we're celebrating the American Music Awards 20th anniversary, here are a few memorable moments from the past.
The great pop stars performed a variety of hit recordings through the past two decades.
Come on and sing my song.
Come on now!
All night long. Woo!
I am woman, hear me roar, in numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back and pretend. Love will keep us together.
Set me free.
What do I say when it's all
seems to be the hardest word.
Sit tight, yellow ribbon around you. Go treat, it's been long years. Do you want me?
You want me?
Come
In addition to the sounds, the American Music Awards also provided some memorable sights.
I can tell by the look in your eyes that you like what you see.
Far out!
In recent years, it was the beat that made America move. The soul of America's music was reflected by the brightest R&B stars.
As a background singer, moved to the other voice on a Mariah Carey number one hit, and has now graduated into his own new single release. And she began her career as a teenage star with number one hits, and she never stopped. To present the Adult Contemporary Artist Award, here are Trey Lorenz and Tanya Tucker.
Well, you must be a little nervous since somebody you know very well is up for this award.
All right, I am. But the only clue that I'll give everybody is that she's only female among the nominees.
Well, let's see if we can pick her out. The nominees are Michael Bolton, Mariah Carey, and Genesis.
And the winner is
Michael Bolton.
Michael Bolton.
Wow. Thank you so much. I get nervous, so I'm just going to make sure. So I want to thank the greatest manager in the world, Lewis Levin, everyone at Bolton Music. I want to thank everyone at Columbia Records, Sony Music, especially Tommy Mottola, Donnie Einer, Mickey Shuloff, for getting behind me and staying behind me. And I want to thank VH1, BMI. I want to especially thank my family. I want to thank radio for staying behind me all along. And most of all, the fans. Thank you.
He's a singer, a dancer, a songwriter, and record producer, but he's more. He's our co-host, Bobby Brown.
I'm gonna get away.
So get it where you're feeling and let the rhythm snatch ya. Throw a good rhyme so life is coming at ya. As I release another brown batch, you jam that slam and you can't touch the scram. I know you're crammed to understand who I am. Damn, by the way, can I please get this dance? Let's not freelance, cause I'm just getting started. Believe me, that was nothing but a brown party. That's going on and got it going on. Bob and Tang's ready, number one, so flow on. If they hold the house, pump the fist and say, ho!
Our next presenters helped start the hip-hop invasion of popular culture 10 years ago with a song called Sucker MCs. Today, just about everybody under the age of 30 wears sneakers and hooded sweatshirts, knows how to dance to hard, funky beats, and calls their best friend homeboy. 10 million albums later, they're about to release their 7th album entitled Down with the King. Here they are, Run DMC.
Feels good to be here. God willing, next year, we'll be taking one of these boys home.
This is the award for favorite new rap hip-hop artist.
And these nominees are bringing new ideas and energy to music that has the new flavor of the day.
For favorite new artist, rap, hip-hop. Arrested Development. Criss Cross. TLC.
Word up. I like to say hip hop array, and the winner is my posse, Criss Cross. Word up.
Hey, yo, first of all, we want to thank God for making all this happen. Next, we want to thank our fans, because we wouldn't be here today for selling 5 million records, too. Next, we want to thank our record label, Rough House Columbia.
Yo, check this out. First of all, I want to thank our man Jermaine Dupri, our producer, DJ Nabs. We want to thank our families. We'd like to thank Dianna, Tommy Mottola, Rough House Columbia, our management, ERI, our business managers, Bill Preston, Willie Carter. We want to thank our hood, the Greenbrier in College Park. We want to thank the House Gang. And we want to send peace to all our homies. And we also want to thank Run DMC. Because if it wasn't for them, rap wouldn't be where it's at. Peace.
great hits by Wynonna, Bon Jovi, and Billy Ray Cyrus when the 20th Annual American Music Awards continues.
February's jamming and ABC's Got the Stuff with special episodes of all your favorite series like Step by Step in Hawaii. And a great lineup of blockbuster movies like Driving Miss Daisy and Dick Tracy to exciting new world premieres like The Flintstones in prime time. Plus the season's hottest specials with stars like Billy Ray Cyrus. And on February 10th, the television event of the year, Oprah Winfrey interviews Michael Jackson live.
Here's a lucky performer. She had a second chance and didn't even need it.
She was already on top as half of one of the all-time top country duos. She's now a solo star. She stayed on top with a debut double platinum album. She is one of today's outstanding hot country artists.
Ladies and gentlemen, singing a song written by her mother, Naomi Judd, here's our co-host, Wynonna.
Please let me in, 'cause I just can't go through another heartache again. Pretty lies and alibis, how could I be so blind? afraid he'll always be. He was my strongest weakness, and I'm afraid he'll always be.
Our next presenters could be described as a garage band that came out of the garage.
They came out far enough to record the biggest selling EP of all time. They have a new album called America's Least Wanted.
Here they are, Ugly Kid Joe.
A lot of thought goes into selecting a band's name.
So let's check out the name of the heavy metal hard rock nominees.
For favorite artist, heavy metal hard rock. Def Leppard. Metallica. Red Hot Chili Peppers.
And the winner is Metallica! Look, another one. As you probably know, the last couple of times I've been up here in this situation, I've been rather long-winded, so I'll try and keep it really short this time. We've had a few of these awards here in the last couple of years, and what makes this one really special is because this one comes from all the people up on the balcony there. Thank you so much, okay? Thank you. Yeah. Our next presenters have been named the favorite country band, duo, or group every year since 1983, including tonight. Altogether, they've won 16 American Music Awards. That's quite a record. Ladies and gentlemen, Randy, Jeff, Teddy, and Mark, Alabama.
These three new artist nominees had a year that any old superstar would be very proud of.
A hot-selling duo, a female veteran newcomer, and a male who's skyrocketed into chart heaven.
Can you guess who they are? Here they come.
For favorite new artist country,
get down, turn around, go to town.
Brooks and Dunn.
I said, don't tell my heart.
Billy Ray Cyrus.
Just don't think you'd understand.
Wynonna.
She is his only.
And the winner is Billy Ray Cyrus.
Don't tell my heart on every breaking heart. Just don't think he'd understand. And if you tell my heart,
thank you all. Thank you very much. What a dream come true.
I love all of you people, all you fans, all you people. I want to thank one other person that I forgot last time, sitting out there in TV land somewhere back in Tennessee. One heck of a songwriter, the guy that wrote Achy Breaky Heart, Don Von Tress, we all love you. We wouldn't be here without the song. All you fans, God bless you all, and thank you for making this old boy's dreams come true. I love you. Thank you very much. Someday, bye.
Billy Ray Cyrus and Bon Jovi performances, plus we'll learn the winners of the Country Album Award when the American Music Awards return.
What is it with skin color?
Not every black man robs and steals.
Nobody's really black or white.
This country is not about racism.
We're just shades of a single protein.
We're all human beings.
You Too and In Vogue and Annie Lennox help us with what we think is one of the most important after-school specials you may ever see. Shades of a Single Protein, Thursday.
The 20th Annual American Music Awards will continue in a moment. An ABC News brief. Now from Washington, Cookie Roberts.
Good evening. President Clinton today appointed his wife, Hillary, to head a new task force. Its mission, a major health care reform package in the next 100 days. Sears announced today it was closing its catalog sales division and laying off 50,000 employees. Later on Nightline, can the president keep his pledge to lift the ban on gays in the military?
Behind the scenes at the American Music Awards tonight at 11.
As a teenager, she had already turned out a multi-platinum album. He's 15 years old. He's already a music business veteran. Last year, he had a top 10 album. To present the award for favorite country album, here are Debbie Gibson and Tevin Campbell.
The nominees for favorite country album are
The Chase, Garth Brooks. Some Gave All, Billy Ray Cyrus. For My Broken Heart, Reba McEntire. Also, everybody, please help to continue to support the fight against AIDS. Okay. The winner is...
For My Broken Heart, Reba McEntire.
Well, for all of you who know what Garth Brooks and Billy Ray Cyrus have done for country music, I'm kind of in shock by this right here. But because this was such a special album for me, it was an album that paid tribute to some people that I lost in an airplane crash in 91. So to the families, to the friends, and to the rest of my organization, I dedicate this album and share it with Garth and Billy Ray, two tremendous friends of mine. Thank you all so much. Their latest album is Keep the Faith, and the fans have gotten the message. Here they are, Bon Jovi.
Trying hard to capture the moment, this morning I don't know. Cause a bottle of vodka still lies in my head. Some blonde give me nightmares, think that she's still in my bed. As I dream about movies they won't make of me. With
with an ironclad fist. I wake up to French kiss the morning. While some marching band keeps its own beat in my head while we're talking about all of those things that I long to believe about love. The truth, what you mean to me, and the truth is, baby, you're all that I need.
Records and concerts and turn out hit records. Please welcome Sawyer Brown.
We are here to present the favorite new pop rock artist.
And to do that, we have to let you know who's nominated.
And those nominations are based on record sales information compiled by the SoundScan Point of Sale Tracking System and Radio and Records, a leading music trade publication.
And here are the nominees.
For favorite new artist, pop rock. Arrested Development.
And the winner is Pearl Jam. First time I've ever done this, and it's pretty heavy. First, I guess, we want to keep it short. We want to thank everybody at Epic and Sony, and I wish the rest of the band were here. I actually paid Eric Johnson, our tour manager, to come up and stand here with me because I was kind of nervous. But just thanks to everybody, and thanks.
Coming up next, Billy Ray Cyrus and Metallica on the 20th Annual American Music Awards.
Tuesday.
Can I say something about your cologne?
Love is not blind.
You got any other complaints you'd like to get off your huge chest while we're at it?
Okay, your hair.
Here we go.
Civil Wars.
This conversation is over.
Tuesday.
The names of our next two presenters are almost spelled the same. He is a singing star who went to the top of the adult contemporary charts and won the New Artist Award last year. She is the singer-songwriter who made a platinum album with Scandal and whose new solo album has gone gold. Here they are, Michael W. Smith with an I and Patti Smyth with a Y.
They're Smith and Smyth, here we are.
Okay, we're about to let you know the winner of the award for Soul R&B Album.
In the meantime, I can tell you this. It's either going to be a man, a woman, or a group of fabulous females. Here are the possibilities.
For favorite album, Soul R&B.
Just call my name.
Unplugged, Mariah Carey. Funky Divas in Vogue. Dangerous, Michael Jackson.
And the winner is...
Funky Divas in Vogue!
Thank God, first and foremost, for putting us right here on the stage tonight. And all the fans, we thank you so very much.
God bless you.
It's you that makes this happen. Thank you so much.
We'd like to thank our producers, Denzel Foster and Thomas McElroy. We'd like to thank our management, David Lombard. We'd like to thank our record company, East West Records, Sylvia Rohn, and everybody. Thank you also, Atlantic Records.
They were last year's winners of the Heavy Metal Hard Rock New Artist Award, and that's what they're going to present this evening.
They won that honor by having a debut album that went Platinum Plus. Say hello to CJ, Bill, Perry, and Michael. Firehouse.
I will never forget last year when we won this award.
Yeah,
Yeah, last year was a lot more fun than this year for us because this year we didn't win nothing.
So we wish good luck to all the nominees this year.
Come on over. For favorite new artist, heavy metal, hard rock. Mr. Big.
Deep inside, I hope you feel it too.
Feel it too.
Pearl Jam. Ugly Kid Joe.
And the winner is another epic band, Pearl Jam!
Well, now I can make up for what I didn't say last time. Wow. Kelly Curtis and Michael Goldstone are up there somewhere, and it's thanks to them, too. And again, thanks to everyone else. Thanks.
Last year, our next performer had a number one selling album, Some Gave All, and a number one selling single, Achy Breaky Heart. His concerts are all sellouts, and this year, he's going to have his own ABC special. A winner of two awards this evening, ladies and gentlemen, with his band Sly Dog, my personal friend, Billy Ray Cyrus.
She used to cry when I... She couldn't buy the lies I told. All she wanted was to be needed, someone that she could call her own. Her love I know I took for granted, till she walked out of my door. Too little too late to say I'm sorry, 'cause she's not crying anymore. And she's not crying anymore. She ain't lonely any longer. There's a smile upon her face. A new love takes my place. She's not crying anymore. Really doing well now. She's picked herself up off the ground. I wasn't there when I was needed, but I was there to let her down. Sometimes you know I feel so foolish. If I knew then what I know, another tear would never fall, 'cause I'd give all of my all if we could work things out somehow. But she's not crying anymore. She ain't lonely any longer. There's a smile upon her face. A new love takes my place. She's not crying. And she's not crying anymore. She ain't lonely any longer. There's a smile upon her face. A new love takes my place. She my place. She's not crying anymore.
If you want to catch more of America's hottest young star, Billy Ray Cyrus. Don't miss the Billy Ray Cyrus special, Dreams Come True, Wednesday, February 17th on ABC.
The 20th Annual American Music Awards will continue in a moment.
On the next Oprah, this woman gave birth to her own grandchild.
To present the nominees for New Soul and R&B Artists, here are Weird Al Yankovic and TLC.
Stop, yo!
The nominees for Soul R&B Favorite New Artist are...
All right, Arrested Development, Jodeci, and Criss Cross.
And the winner is...
Oh, well, it's TLC since we can't get it over. Criss Cross! Hey, yo, Criss.
What's up?
We want another one.
You don't hear me, Joe. Check this out, though. You know, we just want to thank, all our fans for buying our records. I want to thank my mom, my grandma, my cousin, my aunt, all my family. And that's about it.
I want to thank my family and my friends and everybody who made this happen. And I want to thank God, because he made all this happen. Ladies and gentlemen, from the legendary Fleetwood Mac, Mick Fleetwood and Christine McBee.
For Pop Rock Favorite Album, the nominees are...
Dangerous, Michael Jackson. Totally Crossed Out, Criss Cross. Uptown Baby, U2. And the winner is...
Dangerous, Michael Jackson!
Michael Jackson!
I really wasn't expecting to win. Thank you again, Teddy Riley, the public. I love you very much. Thank you.
In the past 20 years, only two recipients of the Award of Merit have not been performing artists.
They were Motown founder Berry Gordy Jr. and the songwriting giant Irving Berlin. This year, we honor another behind-the-scenes hero of American music. To tell us about him, here is a legendary artist, his friend, Grace Slick.
Thank you. Thank you. This year's honoree was a man who was rarely seen or heard by the American public. But his live events and clubs and concerts and memorable tours have been enjoyed by millions and millions of music fans for more than a quarter of a century. Let's look into the autobiography which he wrote recently, Bill Graham Presents, and find out more about him.
My group, Jefferson Airplane, was San Francisco-based and starting to get some recognition in the late 60s. And Bill Graham's legendary Fillmore West was where we did a lot of our playing. In those days, San Francisco was the psychedelic, flower children, love-in capital of the world, and Fillmore West was its musical heart.
I happened to be in San Francisco in 1965. We were part of that whole thing, the move.
The Bay Area gave off a feeling of, let's hang out.
Jefferson Airplane, John Handy Quintet, and Sam Thomas and Mystery Trend and the Great Society are all playing Friday at Fillmore Auditorium Friday, December 10th, and I would like to go if I could.
In the 70s, Bill expanded into historic concerts and tours with top rock acts like the Rolling Stones, Led Zeppelin, The Doors, Small Faces with Rod Stewart, and The Grateful Dead.
Bill was our power guy, you know. He's the guy that made rock and roll into an art form. But he loved the drama, you know. He loved to dickering with agents and managers and stuff like that. It was part of what was fun for him. Bill himself is larger than life, an amazing guy. I've just missed a friend.
You really, really serve people really well by giving you more than entertainment. So we're all very grateful to Bill Graham for your contribution to the arts. And we'll see you there when we get there. Thank you, Bill. Are you ready
for the bank call? In the 80s, Bill called on his friends to help him help others.
He was able to use his position in music to raise money and raise consciousness for a variety of causes. Bill Graham was my friend, and Bill was the best person I ever met.
This was Bill helping pull things together during an Amnesty International tour that went to 6 cities in 2 weeks. In the 70s, there were the United Farm Workers, Aid to Biafra, even Save the Cable Car. And in the 80s, besides the ones mentioned, there was Cambodian Relief, Live Aid, Crackdown, the International Peace Concert in Moscow, Human Rights Now, and dozens more. I guess his own turbulent childhood in Nazi Germany gave him the drive to right some of the world's wrongs. And when called upon, he found it practically impossible to say no.
Beside his musical activities, Bill showed an unexpected talent for stealing scenes in blockbuster movies.
Yeah! And to prove it, we're going to give you some entertainment we know you're going to like.
The money that you and Meyer put up was not a gift. This was a favor that I let you in on.
Fine. Fine, and let us out now, at cost. No profit. You want out, you're out!
I remember it was October 25th. And it was kind of typical of Bill, actually, that he was there, even though the weather was so bad. He always liked to come to the shows and come backstage early and, you know, and talk and tell a few stories. And as he did on this occasion, and then we went on stage. And I remember there was a power outage towards the end of the show, just very briefly. And we later learned, it wasn't in the morning till we learned, that it was Bill's helicopter that had struck the tower that had caused the outage. And we were shocked, obviously, and really disbelieving. He seemed so indestructible. And there it was, you know, we'd lost maybe the most important non-musician in the music business for the last quarter century or so. And we miss him a lot.
A week later, 22 top musical acts and 500,000 fans gathered at Golden Gate Park to help Robin Williams say goodbye to Bill.
Well, I'd just like you all right now, to just the entire group, just to go, yo, Bill. I think you heard that. Thank you for coming to honor an amazing man. If Gandhi could dance, I think it would go something like Bill. A man who had a great sense of conscience and also a great sense of fun. And this proves it, man. Wow. All these tents and all these people. Woo! Rejoice! Rejoice! Amazing Grand, how sweet the man. Thank you.
Here's another one of Bill's friends, Stephen Stills.
Can you hear the past calling from Armageddon's side? When everyone's talking and no one is listening, how can we decide? Do we find the cause of freedom digging every in the ground? Mother Earth will swallow you, laying your body down.
Bill was the only manager this next star ever had. Here to present the Award of Merit is Eddie Money.
It's my honor tonight to present this award to Bill Graham's two sons, who've seen a lot of rock and roll, probably more than all of us together, David and Alex. David. These kids are growing like weeds. The inscription reads, from his early rock concerts at Fillmore West and East in the 1960s to his all-star presentations benefiting worldwide victims of disease, homelessness, and hunger in the 80s and 90s, he encouraged and promoted many of the top music stars of the past 25 years. The American Music Awards Merit recognizes Bill Graham, January 25th, 1993.
Thank you very much. I truly believe my father was a great visionary of our time. If you were here today, he would remind us that we all represent a great collective of power, and especially now, each one of us can tap into that power and make a difference by implementing positive change. I love him very much. I can only hope to help as many people as he did. Thank you.
I'm sure my father is very proud to receive this honor. He could be a tough person to deal with, but he always looked out for people. People in the audience, people struggling in their lives, people oppressed. This was his passion. Thank you.
Coming next, Metallica and the Top Male Vocalist Awards for the 20th anniversary edition of the American Music Awards continues.
Presenting the award for favorite country male artist, please welcome Restless Heart and Kathy Mattea.
This
is one of the most successful years country music has ever had.
And it's reflected in the caliber of these male artist nominees.
Here they are. Garth Brooks, Billy Ray Cyrus, Vince Gill, Alan Jackson.
And the winner is... his Garthness, Garth Brooks! I will say my best. You'll never run me down. Like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination. If I never try, so I will sail my best. You
like to thank Bob and Pam, my managers. I'd like to thank all the guys out on the road and all the guys that support me there at the record label at Liberty. I'd like to thank my wife, Sandy, and our precious daughter, Taylor, back home. I'd like to thank God, and I'd like to say something to you guys up there. I'm enjoying my 8 months off. I'm getting to know my little girl, and I'm enjoying my time. The one thing I must ask of you, we're coming back. Please don't forget me, okay? God bless you.
Their current album has been on the chart for 75 weeks. It has sold 6.5 million copies. A winner tonight. Please welcome James, Lars, Kirk, and Jason. Metallica. We'll be right back.
This award is for soul and R&B male artists over the past 20 years. The winners here, really happy to receive this watch.
Even though this has been the year of the woman, there's a pretty impressive group of men up for the Soul Artist Award. And the nominees are Bobby Brown, Tevin Campbell, Michael Jackson, Gerald Levert, and the winner is Bobby Brown!
First of all, I'd like to thank Jesus, first and foremost. I'd like to thank everybody up there, everybody in the house. Oh, I'd just like to thank my record company, all the producers that worked on the album, Ellie and Babyface, Teddy Riley, everybody. Thank you again. God bless you all. My wife. I like to thank my wife. I love you, honey. I'm on my way home.
Last year, our next presenter won the Adult Contemporary Artist Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Natalie Cole.
Thank you and good evening. I was supposed to be presenting this award with a good friend of mine, Mr. Luther Vandross. He cannot be here tonight. He's in the studio, but I'm sure you guys will let him know that he's missed. Okay, the nominees for favorite pop rock artist are Bryan Adams, Michael Bolton, Eric Clapton, and Michael Jackson. And the winner is Michael Bolton.
Thank you so much. I want to thank some great producers I've worked with recently, Walter Afanasieff, David Foster for Timeless. I want to thank the great, great singers who inspired me, Marvin Gaye, Sam Cooke, Otis Redding, so many great, great artists before us. This means a lot to me. Thank you all very, very much.
The 20th anniversary edition of the American Music Awards returns after this. Nominations are based on information compiled by Radio and Records, a leading music trade publication, and the SoundScan, sales tracking system. The independent survey firm of Broadcast Research and Consulting Incorporated sends the ballots to a representative sample of record buyers. The ballots are tabulated by the national firm of KPMG Pete, and the results are placed in sealed envelopes until they are opened at the time of presentation. Travel provided by Continental. One airline can make a difference. Over 200 destinations throughout the world. That's the difference on Continental. For the 20th Annual American Music Awards, this is Charlie O'Donnell speaking.
I'm Cokie Roberts. Later on Nightline, lifting the ban on gays in the military. Bill Clinton faces a fight with Congress and the Pentagon. Can he keep his pledge?
This is Charles Gibson.
And Nancy Snyderman.
Tomorrow, the state of African Americans in 1993, then helping the jogger in your family get through winter.
Plus, John Goodman and singer Suzanne Vega tomorrow on Good Morning America.